promote SDI, innovation-driven development, and transfer of technology through south-to-south cooperation while strengthening strategic partnerships with countries of the North on favorable terms.
The G77 plus China is the largest intergovernmental organization for developing countries. It is used as a platform to articulate and promote the country's collective economic interests and increase their joint negotiating capacity on all major international economic issues. The coalition was initially started by 77 countries, but now it has 135 member countries from Asia, Latin America, Africa, and the Caribbean. The G77 plus China summit for the senior officials this evening kicked off at Speak Conventional Center in Munyonyo. Officiating at the opening ceremony, the Permanent Secretary of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, Vincent Bajire, noted with concern that the international financial architectures are no longer responsive to financing the needs of developing countries. He urged the G77 members to reform global financing institutions to address issues of debt management in developing countries.
To reform global financial institutions and architecture, addressing related issues such as debt management and giving greater voice to developing countries are very critical for our group. Against this background of the varied obstacles and challenges, we need to work collectively in partnership to reassert the value of global cooperation as we seek to build a more prosperous world for all.
Bajire expressed concern that the summit has happened at the time when the world is facing multiple challenges like geopolitical tensions, financial and economic challenges, plus climate change crisis. His wish is to see member countries strengthening multilateralism for a fairer, more equitable and prosperous world.
The G77 and China, therefore, has an opportunity and an important role to play in the strengthening of multilateralism for a fairer, more equitable and prosperous world.
According to Bajire, developing countries' efforts to implement the Agenda 2030 must also be backed up by concrete actions on technology transfer and capacity building, as well as north-to-south cooperation to foster industrialization and investment in quality, reliable, sustainable, and resilient infrastructure.
The implementation is lagging, as we all know, partly on account of the COVID-19 pandemic and its impact. It is therefore imperative that the concerted are made to scale up mobilization of resources in terms of financial, capacity building, and technology required to deliver the agenda and the SDGs, which mainly aim at eradicating poverty, addressing climate change, and indeed leaving no one behind.
This meeting has been chaired by Cuba's permanent representative to the United Nations in the United Nations General Assembly, Ambassador Pedro Luis Pedroso Cuesta. He reaffirmed their commitment to continue supporting Uganda in several aspects.
Satisfaction that with your support, today our group has updated positions on the most urgent international problems that affect us. Most support to the Republic of Uganda, and we wish Uganda the greatest success for their chairmanship in the 2024 year. Cuba will continue to play an active and constructive role as a member of the G77 and China.
Report by Jaliat Namwaya for the news.